Okay, this is the power jump roping drill. There has to be hundreds of videos or instructions on jump roping. And you might think, well, why do I even need instruction on jump roping? You just get a rope and you jump around and lift your feet up and move your hands. It's a little more than that, and I think I might have developed pretty good technique for power jumping, and which I will explain presently. But first, let me elucidate a little bit on the actual jump rope itself. I feel that this type of jump rope with cylindrical beads is the best jump rope to get. You have your leather or leather-like strap jump ropes too, which are pretty good. But I think this hasn't beat, and I'll tell you why. Because you have to modify it first. This is the rope that came with the actual jump rope when I bought it. Now, if you can see that I put a much more sturdy and hefty rope in there. What that does, it makes the rope a lot heavier, especially towards the bottom of it as you're moving with it. You want a heavy rope, as heavy as possible. You don't want to be using chains or anything like that, but a heavy rope is a good start. Now, what this power jumping routine does, it incorporates what I call flurries. And you might have heard what flurries are before, flurry and boxing, blah, 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 blah. You know, welterweights, lightweights, really flurry very fast. Flurries in this context is jumping as fast as you can for a predetermined amount of steps. By predetermined amount, I mean 64 steps. Why 64? Well, I've always liked number 8, for one. And I found that it's a natural multiplicand when you are jumping rope. Okay. The way it works is a set of 8 is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So it's 2, 2, and 1, 1, 1, 1. That makes an 8. Okay? Or an octave. You can say it's an octave. So 8 octaves will make 64. So you have 8 times 8 octets to make a 64-step flurry. This will come clear as you see it. But the relevancy here is you intersperse these 64-step flurries in the length of your jump rope routine for that day, for your set. For example, if you are going to jump for 20 minutes, you could incorporate 3 64-step flurries in that 20 minutes. So you'll jump at a regular pace, then you go fast, 64 steps, then you slow down, go for the regular pace to catch your breath, then you do another 64 steps, then you slow down. It sort of regiments the amount of flurry time that you do, and you can actually gauge yourself better. You don't want to just, well, you could just go flurrying for, you know, you might think 90 seconds or 20 seconds. You don't know how many steps you've actually taken. So as you progress with this power jump roping drill, just say you do 20 minutes with 3 flurries. Then maybe 6 months down the road, you'll be doing 6 flurries within a 20-minute time span. That is kind of scientifically increasing your flurry speed, your endurance, and your footwork also. I have never seen really anything quite this systematic in jump roping before. So let me start out, and I'll do a round for one song, and I will incorporate 2 64-step flurries. Now, something else to be said. It's uncanny how you can keep in your mind where in that flurry you are in case you miss. Okay, like if you 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 16, okay? Then you do another 16, and then boom, you miss. And you just resume on that third octet. So you know you've already done 2. You don't have to start at the beginning of that particular flurry. You start on the third octet and go, and if you miss again on the sixth octet, You start on the sixth, and you normally have six, seven, and eight till you finish that flurry. That's that flurry of eight octet steps. Okay? It's really not that difficult of a concept. Again, it's a simple thing, but it is very effective if used the right way. Okay, I guess that's all I really have to say about it. I'm going to do a round for one song and try to incorporate two octets in there. And then maybe I'll say something if I have any breath after it. If I have any wind, I will maybe explain a little more. Okay, so here we go. Song. I did 264 step flurries. I start at regular pace, did a 64 step flurry, work that in to myself by going regular pace for whatever 2 minutes, 3 minutes, and then doing another 64 step flurry, and then ending up that way. One thing to remember, right after you get done with a flurry, like I just did, your body's saying, stop, don't jump anymore, I've had it. Well, that's why you slow down, go with the pace of the music, and work that flurry into your body. And about 40 seconds after the flurry, for a minute after the flurry, or 2 minutes, your body will have its second wind, a third wind. Remember what Billy Joel said, don't forget your second wind. So practice this. Keep on practicing it. It's a long-term strategy, but the 64-step flurries are a very good basic unit of this routine. All right, work out hard and be strong.